Sydney commuters are still being urged to tap on and pay for their train fare despite station gates being left open. Let's go live now to Sarah Stewart, who's at Central Station. Sarah, what's prompted this?
Well, Jane, it is all about the industrial action that's been going on for some time and it's set to continue. But this is what it is like at train stations today. You get to walk straight through the gates. They are open from today until September 6. No one is checking you go through. But the government is still urging you to use one of these to tap on and off with your Opal card. They are saying they will lose $10 million in revenue if people are not tapping on and off for the next 3 weeks. We've been talking to some people here this morning. Lots of them say, though, they are supporting the train drivers. If it is about safety, they want the safest trains possible on our rail network. But look, if this is not resolved soon, there will be another strike action on Wednesday, causing disruptions, and then over the next few weeks as well. There's different lines that are going to be impacted each time, and then at the end of the month again, they're going to not drive all the foreign-made trains again, which is again about 70% of the fleet. Jane.
Okay, Sarah, thank you. The gates at train stations across Sydney will stay open for the next few weeks, but the government still wants you to pay for your ride. We'll go live now to Sarah Stewart, who's at Central Station. Sarah, this is all part of the union's industrial action.
It is indeed, Jane, but have a look. The gates are open. You can walk through without paying, but have a look at the people behind me. Most people are still tapping on and off. I don't know if they don't realise that the gates are open, but this is exactly what the government wants you to do. If you are going through, they want you to tap on and off. If you do not, they say they could lose $10 million in revenue over the next 3 weeks because these gates are going to stay open until September 6. But I also want to tell you there is a bit of a catch. If you tap on somewhere, you need to tap off when you get off the train as well, because otherwise you will be charged the maximum fare for the day. So if you're not going to do it at all, don't do it at all. If you tap on, you must tap off. We've spoken to a lot of people here this morning and there is a lot of support for the train drivers.
Everyone still pays anyway. Everyone taps.
If you don't have to, why should you? And not only that, I support the train drivers.
I don't want to risk it, so probably, yeah, because the police are regularly like patrolling the trains anyway, so I don't want to risk like losing $200.
So the station staff won't fine you, but the police, if they are on the train, they could still fine you if you don't have a ticket. Of course, this has been going on for some time. The train drivers are saying it is about safety. The government is saying it is about money. And unfortunately, it is going to continue. If they don't come to an agreement, get something in writing by Wednesday. There will be more action on Wednesday and again later in the month. Jane.